Hey Spartans, Mike Morris here, Vice President of Production at Spartan Race. Here at the WW Motocross Ranch in Jacksonville, Florida, preparing for the upcoming race. And we're doing everything we possibly can to make sure that you're gonna have an awesome, fun, and safe experience. I'm gonna walk you through a few of those things today. All right guys, here we are in parking. When you come in, we're gonna allow probably about 10 feet in between cars as opposed to the usual 6 feet, just to make sure that people aren't too congested here in the parking lot. If you try to show up earlier than 30 minutes prior to heat time, we're gonna ask you to turn around and go back to your car. So we're gonna enforce that. Again, that's going back to how we're doing our best to control social distancing. Right about here is we're gonna have our health screen. We're gonna walk up, we're gonna have medics lined up all along here. And there are a couple things. One, they're gonna visually observe you. They're gonna make sure you have a runny nose, make sure you're not coughing, make sure you have pale skin. And then they're gonna take your temperature using a non-contact IR thermometer in your forehead. We're gonna make sure you don't have a fever or present a fever that is 100.4. If you don't pass the health screening, we're gonna ask you questions, we're gonna do the visual assessment, and we're gonna do the temperature test. If you can't pass that, we're gonna ask you to leave politely. We'll give you a full refund, but it's important to note that if you don't pass those screens, in order to keep everyone else safe, in order to keep our staff and customers safe, we're gonna ask you to leave and you and your car to leave. And again, we'll give you that full refund. We purposely created gaps in between the tents. We've reduced the number of lanes per tent to reduce the density of people in those areas. We've put up some of the clear sidewalls like I talked about to protect to separate the staff and the volunteers from the racers, just to ensure that we're creating an environment to ensure social distancing. We're gonna have these all over the course, all over the festival. It's what most people already know. You know, it's that reminder, we're gonna stay 6 feet apart. Social distancing is an important part of making this event safe. And that starts within parking, like we're having the cars be spaced 10 feet apart. All throughout the festival, we created different lanes that are gonna space people out. The registration tent, you notice a different spacing in the tent to allow people to walk through without being close. We reduced the number of lanes and lines per each tent. That's our way of being able to maintain and manage the right number of people on site. And so we need to know who's showing up and when they're showing up. So no day of registrations, there's no spectators, there's no kids race. So please don't try to enter if you're a spectator or if you're coming to register that day of. Only those that are registered in advance will be allowed to enter. All right, Spartans, putting some hand sanitizer on here. We're gonna have a lot of this all over festival. It's gonna be after every major touch point. When you use it, put on your hands, rub it for a good 10 to 20 seconds at least. Make sure we kill those germs. And just obviously, as you guys know, keep your hands out of your face, off your face, out of your eyes and your mouth. I'm wearing a mask right now, face covering. All the staff and volunteers will be wearing these on race day. And then you'll see that throughout the festival. We would like it if you did as a racer to wear it throughout the festival, but it's not a requirement. We do ask that you obviously keep your distance from anyone that's not wearing a mask. Be extra sensitive to that. Some of the things you're gonna see on site as well as on course, you're gonna see plastic sneeze guards, we call them, but they're actually really big. You know, we have these plexiglass style barriers that are gonna protect and separate the customers from the person working that area, whether it's a volunteer or a staff member. We're doing our best to set conditions for proper social distancing. And so anywhere there's typically a line, you're gonna see this gate. When you walk up, it says Spartan, lane enter here. Boom, here's your spot. This is where you queue up if there is a queue. And this is where you run up the obstacle. This is ensuring that we have 6 feet of separation between each lane of customer running up the actual obstacles. You're gonna see that all throughout the course on almost every single obstacle. Here's where you queue up where it says Spartan wait here. And if you happen to come up on that person, you got this spot and then the next spot. We are running 300 people per hour as opposed to the normal 1,000 or 1,200. So one of the ways we are trying to reduce the congestion on course is to have smaller heat sizes. So I'm not too worried about the obstacles, but just in case they're here to be super safe. In case you missed it, Spartan Tough Mudder Joint Forces, we have got something special for all you Spartans out here today. We have the Tough Mudder Obstacle Electric Heel, which is basically electrified barbed wire. And so when you walk up on the course, to the right, you're gonna see the Spartan barbed wire, and to the left, you're gonna see the electric heel, where if you wanna go for a little low crawl and get a little shock, you're more than welcome to go that route. Come with me, we're gonna go to festival now. Food and beverage is different, start line's different. There won't be any sort of festival challenges. Festival activations are limited. The sponsors won't have any sort of activations. The really only things you can interact with will be food and beverage. You can buy prepackaged food, nothing will be made on site. And then the drinks we'll have and the beer we'll have already is already in a can. We're not gonna pour it there on site. So in merch, you might typically find one pod that sells men's products, one pod that might sell women's product. In this case, each pod is gonna have the same SKUs. So if you walk up and you see three things you like in this pod, they're gonna be the same things in the next pod and the same things in the next pod. It's not like you have to walk up and say, hey, I want one of these from this section and one from this section. So as you walk up the start corral, keep an ear out because we're gonna say, hey, all the A15 racers, let's go. And we're gonna take the first 25, we're gonna load you in, the next 25 load you in, and as those groups 25 leave, we'll load in another group of 25, and we can hold up to 75 people in the corral. So when you're in there, just follow the chicanes, and then look down. There's gonna be some markings on the ground that's gonna denote where you should be standing and make sure you ensure that 6 feet of spacing. As you get up towards the actual start line, there'll be some signs on the fence that says wait here, just like that. All right, Spartan, you're gonna get to the end of your 5K. You're gonna be pumped. You're gonna cross the finish line. You're gonna get your medal. And beyond that, there's a subtle change you need to know about. We've spread everything out. So after you get your medal, you're gonna go through a bit of chicane. You're gonna approach here, you're gonna take your photo. If you wanna bypass the photo area, there's a clear bypass. You can go around the photo area. And then you're gonna go and you're gonna actually cut your own chip off. Typically we have volunteers or staff doing this. Now it's on you. You're gonna walk up to your tent. You can go to either side. We're gonna have scissors sitting in a sanitizer solution. You're gonna pull it out. You're gonna cut your chip. You're gonna strip the chip off the wristband. You're gonna throw the wristband into a garbage can. And you're gonna carry that chip up to the next tent, which is where you're gonna get your shirt. Walk up to the t-shirt tent. You're gonna look at the signs. It's gonna be men over here, women over here. And then actually in the actual tent, it'll be small, mediums on one side, large, extra large, double X on the other side. Follow the arrows to the right size. We're gonna give you a full package. It's gonna be a bag that's gonna have your t-shirt, and it's gonna have all our sponsored product that comes with it. All right, Spartan, it's worth me talking about what we expect of you as a racer. A lot of people in the health community might refer to this as a social contract. We've done everything we can to set up a safe and awesome experience for you here. We've got all the hand sanitizer in the world. We've got markings for lanes and lines that create the social distancing requirements. We've narrowed down the number of people we should have on site to make sure we have the right capacity on site and the right number of people. At the end of the day, if you guys as racers don't follow the guidelines you have in place, it's not gonna work. So please, when you show up, follow the guidelines, follow the rules, listen to the volunteers, listen to the staff, stay away from the high fives, stay away from the hugs. If you have to, give a little elbow rub, maybe a little louder roo, but let's stay away from all the physical contact from each other for people we don't know.